Join me in welcoming to the stage from Schechter Wealth, a 2023 Forbes Shook Top RIA firm, CEO Marc Schechter and Vice President of Advanced Design, Mr. Jordan Smith. All right. Here we go.
Thank you, Bonnie. Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon. I was so excited and I'm so humbled to have been chosen here by Finseca to stand in front of our industry's best and brightest and share a little bit about our organization. I saw so many friends as I walked in here today, relationships I've built over decades, and we are so fortunate to be a part of this wonderful community. This is a bit of an emotional experience for me as I know how much my father cared about and supported AALU for so many decades. He was struck with pancreatic cancer 13 years ago and passed away 16 months later at the age of 75. Many in this room knew my father. He was, and I am, so grateful for everything AALU and now Finseca has done for our industry and therefore our clients. When Marc, Maggie, Dan, and the rest of the team at Finseca asked me to speak here, we discussed many of the different topics we could touch on. We often speak around the country to groups of advisors about legal and estate planning strategies, the latest and greatest product concepts, or premium financing structures. Interestingly, after the Finseca team learned more about Schechter, they felt the audience would love to learn how we built our business and our revenue sharing strategic partner program. It is my hope that each of you learn something about what we're doing and decide to apply one or more of these philosophies to your business. All of us in this room have taken different paths to get here. We've all been influenced by different mentors and company philosophies in our industry. Our origins at Schechter have been a blend of both the career and independent channels. My father's uncle, Rudy Lightman, joined New York Life in the Detroit office in 1939. Rudy was a relationship guy and always credited his success to doing what's right for the client and knowing more about the mechanics of how New York Life products worked than any of his competitors. In 1956, Rudy was the number one New York Life agent in the country out of 4,000 agents. In 1973, my father, Robert Schechter, with an engineering degree and an MBA from the University of Michigan, was running a steel plant in Detroit. When bankruptcy disrupted the steel industry, my father joined his uncle Rudy. 3 years later, in 76, my dad, with his engineering mind, pushed Rudy to recognize that New York Life did not have the best products all the time for every client demographic, and he convinced Rudy to go independent. 4 years later, in 1980, Rudy passed away at the age of 69. My father, a constant and curious learner, leaned into technical estate planning. He knew more about tax law than most of the tax attorneys in town. In 1997, even though he placed only one-third of his business with New York Life, it was enough to make him the number one producer at New York Life that year, now out of 12,000 agents across the country. I came along 5 years later, at my age 35, after selling half a business I started. I had started the karaoke concept when I was a junior at the University of Michigan. I built that company into one of the largest corporate meeting and event firms in the country. In 1996, we were an Inc. 500 company, and although my business was doing great, I felt I could do even greater in the financial services world, and I would enjoy working with my father. I was excited to join him, leverage his reputation, and bring a more entrepreneurial mindset to his great professional success to drive both vertical and horizontal growth. So here's a snapshot of what our business looks like today. We are a team of 80 on our payroll, with 50 of us in Metro Detroit and 30 around the country. As you can see on screen, we have many professional designations, including 5 attorneys, CPAs, CFAs, CLUs, and many, many more. What many find surprising about our organization is that only 8 of us are in the business development, while 72 are providing research, design, legal, technology, service, and support to our 8 biz dev folks and 150 of our strategic partners around the country. We have 3 business units. Our life insurance unit manages and services over $10 billion of death benefit. These policies have over $1 billion in cash values spread over 4,500 policies. We serve 2 distinct markets. Our B2C market targets individuals and families with a net worth in excess of $10 million, and our B2B2C market helps other insurance and investment professionals help their clients. Our second business unit is our investment advisory business, which we started only 10 years ago. We are Michigan's fastest growing investment advisory firm and 40th in the country. 4 years ago, we had $1.5 billion under management. We started the year at $3.2 billion this year, and we should surpass $4 billion by the end of the year, all through organic growth. Third, our private capital division started in 2016. We have invested $300 million direct onto the cap tables of 27 private investments. We were early into DraftKings, Peloton, and Reddit. Our clients find this to be an exciting way to access private companies, and this has been a great source of referrals into our business units. I now want to touch on the essence of why and how we have built our business. At Schechter, we follow a business operating system called EOS. Raise your hand if you're familiar with EOS. Right. Keep your hand up if you are operating your business using EOS. Great. So many of you are familiar with this. I met the founder, Gino Wickman, 32 years ago. We were both 25 years old in the Detroit Young Entrepreneurs Organization chapter. He was a coach of mine in my first business in 1999, and I brought his business system to Schechter. If anyone is running their business without some type of structured systems and processes, I highly recommend you adopt one right away. The first part of the EOS process was to determine our why. What is our purpose? Why do we come to work each day? For us, our purpose is to create raving fans and build lifelong relationships. We love when people say great things about us, our company, or a teammate. And there's not much more that pains us than when anyone has anything negative to say about an experience with our company. While it's always nice to fill an order when an attorney calls us and asks us to acquire $10 million of life insurance for a client, if we are not building a relationship with that client where we really care about them and they really care about us, we're missing out on so much of the joy and business opportunity that comes from building lifelong relationships in this industry. Once we identified our purpose, we then went through a process of identifying our core values. Today, we have the same core values we had 22 years ago. These were identified very easily as they were the values of my father and Rudy. We hire, fire, and review by these core values every year. We are the experts is our first core value. A complete wow experience, clients' needs first, and a special place to be and grow. We are the experts. Legal, tax, product, industry are always changing. Are you keeping up? We thirst for knowledge. We invest in knowledge. We are curious as a company. One of our taglines is knowledge creates opportunity, because it does. 11 years ago, we made one of the best investments we've ever made. We knew we needed a bright estate planning expert to join our team, and we found one of the most insurance knowledgeable estate planning attorneys in the country, and he happened to be in our backyard. Jordan Smith was at one of the largest law firms in Detroit. He holds both an undergraduate degree and a law degree from University of Michigan, as well as an LLM from NYU. Jordan, please share with the group a couple insurance strategies that we've been incorporating into our clients' planning.
Sure, thanks, Marc. My introduction to the world of life insurance was a bit different from Marc's. My early years at the law firm were focused on helping clients transfer wealth to younger generations, designing business succession plans that could provide seamless continuity, whether the transferee was a business partner, a family member, or an unrelated third party, and evaluating retirement planning strategies to ensure that they were as tax efficient as possible. During this time, I learned that life insurance, when the right product is designed correctly, could be an incredible tool that greatly increases the chances of a successful outcome. What we want to show you today are just two examples of how we at Schechter use life insurance to help clients accomplish specific objectives. The first case involves estate equalization. This comes up often in discussions with our small business owner clients, and in this particular case, we were working with a married couple in their early 60s with a net worth of $45 million, where the biggest asset, making up about 44% of their total estate, was an auto dealership that they own 100% of. They have three adult children who they want to treat as equally as possible, but only one of the three is in the business. Recognizing the conflicts that can arise when an operating business is divided among active and inactive family members, the clients wanted to transfer the entire business to the child who is active in the business until a review of the numbers showed the tremendous disparity that estate disposition plan would cause. Absent the use of the current high gift and estate tax exemption before it sunsets at the end of 2025, the IRS can be expected to take roughly $12 million off the top of their estate. After allocating the $20 million dealership to the child in the business, each of the other two children would be left with only about $6.5 million apiece. Now, making full use of the client's exemptions before the sunset would reduce the inequality a bit, but the child in the business would still receive more than twice as much as either of the other two. And just to note, the difference is actually a bit bigger than the top line numbers would suggest, because a portion of what's being assigned to the inactive children consists of retirement plan assets that will be subject to ordinary income tax when received. So $8.9 million isn't really $8.9 million. The obvious solution, of course, is life insurance. If they use their exemptions before the sunset and then purchase a minimum of $20 million of life insurance, that will supplement the amount that they can pass to each of the children who aren't in the business and get them close to parity. The key question, though, is what kind of insurance product or products to use. Now, these clients had a high opportunity cost of capital, and while some of our clients are not comfortable with leverage, these clients were. So they were really good candidates for a premium finance program. But the most efficient premium finance designs often involve dropping the death benefit to the minimum non-MEC amount after paying 7 years of premium. We couldn't take the risk of falling below $20 million of net death benefit in the event of an untimely death. We didn't want to risk jeopardizing the long-term policy viability by leaving the death benefit high, and the clients weren't excited about paying the increased cost of starting with a much larger policy. The solution we came up with was to combine a policy designed for maximum death benefit with a policy designed for maximum cash accumulation and to finance the two of them together. The policy structured for death benefit is sometimes described as a skip design and what we also refer to as an option design. It required 4 years of $200,000 premiums for a $15 million death benefit, but then the policy is projected to run for 20 more years without any additional premiums. Premiums kick back in year 25 in increasing amounts using a step design, but by the time we get to that point, the policy designed for cash accumulation is projected to have over $9.3 million of cash value, and they should have no trouble borrowing all future premiums that are needed to sustain the death benefit policy from there. The additional $15 million of death benefit provided by the option design gives us the cushion needed to drop the death benefit on the cash accumulation policy after year 7 and optimize its efficiency. The lowest our combined death benefit ever falls is just under $20.3 million, and in most years we'll have varying amounts of extra death benefit, which may help fully equalize the amounts passing to the three children, $30.7 million at life expectancy. The illustrated out-of-pocket is only a little over $3 million for a projected program IRR of 9.52% tax-free at life expectancy. With this unique design, we were able to help the client solve a serious problem while realizing a very attractive return on the use of their dollars. The second design we'd like to share with you today involves the creation of a flexible structure and the use of a single life insurance policy and program to address two separate needs. The client in this case was a 52-year-old with a net worth of $58 million, more than half of which consisted of majority interests in four different businesses, each of which had a different minority partner. The client explained to us that his plan was to own and operate these businesses for 10 more years. And if he died during those 10 years, his business partners would need life insurance proceeds in order to fund their respective obligations under four separate buy-sell agreements. If he survives the 10 years, however, his plan is to sell the businesses, either to the minority partners or some other third party. And at that point, he would no longer need insurance for buy-sell purposes, but recognizing that he already has a sizable estate tax problem and that it's only going to get worse, he expressed interest in a permanent life insurance policy that can help replenish some of the wealth that he expects will be lost to estate taxes. So this client had a short-term need, 10 years worth of insurance for buy-sell purposes, and a long-term need, insurance for wealth preservation. The most common approach would be to address those needs separately, with term insurance for buy-sell and the permanent policy for wealth preservation. The plan we designed, though, addressed both of these needs with a single policy and program, which produced some pretty incredible results. What we did was have the client create an ILIT and an insurance LLC. The ILIT would be the Class A unit holder in the LLC, and each of the minority business partners would be the Class B unit holders. And we divided the Class B units among them in accordance with how much of a roughly $32 million death benefit each of them would require in order to honor their obligations under their respective buy-sell agreements. We then priced out what it would cost to purchase $32 million of 10-year term insurance on this client if we had decided to address the buy-sell need using term insurance. And because the client had a few health issues and was table-rated, it turned out to be almost $111,000 per year. We divided that $111,000 pro rata among the business partners, and that became what each of them would have to contribute to the LLC as their capital contribution each year. But the LLC didn't buy term insurance. The LLC bought an IUL policy and financed 7 years of premiums of $2 million per year. Because interest rates were near historic lows when we did this case back in 2020, they also bought a derivative that capped their interest rate at a maximum of 3.25% for 10 years. The dollars contributed annually by the business partners are used to pay interest on the premium finance loan, and any additional cash needed for interest would be funded by the ILIT. If the client died while he still owned the businesses, the insurance proceeds would be paid to the LLC. The LLC would repay the premium finance loan, return to the ILIT the dollars that it had contributed toward the program, and then distribute the remaining death benefit to the business partners pro rata so that they can honor their obligations under the buy-sell agreement. But if the client lives for 10 years, sells the businesses, and no longer needs insurance for buy-sell purposes, the operating agreement of the insurance LLC gives the ILIT the right to buy out each of the business partners for a dollar apiece, which is appropriate because all they paid for was term coverage, and that's what they'd already received. And from that point forward, the ILIT will own 100% of the insurance LLC, and we will have effectively converted the life insurance from a buy-sell purpose to an estate preservation purpose. So what have we accomplished? Well, if the ILIT had done the premium finance program all on its own, without the insurance LLC and without involving the business partners, it would have paid a little over $1.6 million in out-of-pocket interest before beginning to accrue in order to receive a $25.5 million death benefit at life expectancy, generating an 8.51% IRR on interest payments to death benefit. But under our structure, the business partners subsidized over two-thirds of the cost of the program by contributing just over $1.1 million toward the out-of-pocket interest cost over 10 years. This reduced the ILIT's contribution down to only $500,000, and after buying out the business partners at the end of year 10, the ILIT still receives the same $25.5 million death benefit. Only now that equates to a 12.11% IRR on interest payments to death benefit. We've been presenting this case study for the past few years because we feel that it does a really nice job of illustrating the way we look at insurance and the term versus perm discussion that many of us regularly have with our clients. But especially over the past year or so, we're frequently asked how the same design would look in today's higher interest rate environment. Would it still work? The answer is yes. What you see here is an updated design that uses current interest rates. We had to increase the annual premium to $2.4 million in order to maintain the $32 million of death benefit that we need for the first 10 years. Between that and the increased interest rate, the total out-of-pocket cost is a little more than twice as much, but it produces a death benefit that is almost twice as much for a 7.88% IRR without involving the business partners and a 9.02% IRR when the business partners subsidize $1.1 million of the out-of-pocket cost.
Jordan, thank you for embodying our core value of knowledge. And get back to the laboratory and come up with some more great ideas. To achieve our purpose of raving fans, it's not good enough to do an adequate job. What can we do with each client interaction from the most complex to the most mundane to make sure they walk away with a wow? The manner in which we handle these details can determine if a client or an advisor will rave or won't rave about Schechter. Therefore, we invest in our servicing as though it's our advertising, because it is. I'll say it again, servicing is our advertising. We are constantly investing in people and technology to enhance the client experience. In 85 years, we have not done one seminar. We don't do radio ads. It's a simple formula. Happy clients equals more referrals. The following are just four of perhaps 100 servicing processes we have built. First, we deliver electronic policy binders to our clients and their advisors after any policy acquisition. And I never use the word insurance sale. We always use acquisition in our organization. No sold illustrations, they're purchased illustrations. We're not selling, we're advising, we're helping them acquire insurance. There's no convincing going on. How often are you in a situation where a client has no idea as to why they acquired a policy 10 years earlier or even 1 year earlier? Having all the whys, hows, and what's memorialized helps our client and our team through each future annual renewal. Second, as term conversion deadlines are approaching, we send out a 12-month prior and a 6-month prior letter. I have seen too often unhealthy clients of other agents who miss this critical deadline, and I never want it to happen under our roof. Third, premium financing annual reviews are an area of our business where we get lots of wows from lots of advisors all over the country. 120 days out from loan renewal, we begin a process. We ultimately deliver a 10-page review that details why they bought the policy, how it was structured, a macro market outlook, the initial funding plan, out-of-pocket interest payments to date, the initial projections, the current projections, collateral analyses, and for IUL policies, we have customized technology to capture and report segment tracking, which can often get very confusing, especially with many carrier statements that simply confuse our clients. Basically, everything the client and their advisors would need to know to engage in a conversation about managing the policy and the loan going forward. Should we skip a premium this year? Should we borrow from the policy and pay back a bank loan? Should we lock in interest rates with derivatives? Fourth, we have invested millions of dollars into a customized CRM software. Smart Office just wasn't cutting it for us. 8 years ago, we started using Microsoft Dynamics as our base. We continue to add functionality each year. On screen are some of the shots of a premium financing module that tracks loan terms, derivative pricing, loan history, and collateral posted. Okay, I'm going to switch gears for a moment and now address the second area of conversation that Marc, Maggie, and Dan asked me to speak about today, our strategic partner program. In 2012, I was with a study group of peers presenting product analysis our team had done on a specific policy. We did a deep dive comparing the costs of a max funded IUL versus purchasing put and call options on Wall Street. Many in the group loved the analysis as well as the educational materials we created. Prior to that day, I hadn't realized how unique our team's capabilities were. Shortly thereafter, we did our first shared revenue case. Happy client, happy advisor. It was great for everybody. In that year, we generated 5% of our revenue through our strategic partner channel. The response and growth has been tremendous. That number is now over 75% of our revenue. We partner with advisors in two areas: advanced design and estate planning, where we help advisors identify opportunities to help their wealthier, more sophisticated clients and prospects. And the second being premium financing strategy, design, implementation, bank negotiation, and service. And while there are vendors in our industry who function as banking intermediaries, our platform is built by advisors for advisors, and our guidance and service is much broader and deeper. Hear for a moment what one of our over 150 strategic partners had to say recently.
So I'm an advisor in Greenville, South Carolina, working with higher net worth clients and business owners. Been doing this for about 11 years. My first case that this came about was through a premium finance case where I realized that I knew a little bit about the insurance planning in that realm, but didn't have enough expertise to really walk a client through it soup to nuts. So I needed a partner, and Schechter rose to the top through referral as a great partner. It was really just a good fit all the way around. And like I said, the clients were so happy they referred us to other clients. I tend to be very selective with partners that I bring on board because obviously it's my name on the line as well. So with Schechter, it was able to build a bridge of trust pretty quickly, realizing that they've been in business for as long as they have, over 80 years. Obviously the longevity is there, and just their values, their commitment to their clients really came through for me when I talked to them. And so it's been an enhancer of the client relationship. I feel like Schechter's an extension of my business in this area. And so we work together as a team, and I feel like we can do more together than I could do on my own. One of the things I appreciate most about Schechter is they put a lot of effort into the servicing side and building the right team. And so they have experts in various realms that they've hired on board internally. And so I think that's built trust. Just the size of the team and the depth of the team has built trust for sure.
Tim and all our strategic partners can benefit from co-branded marketing materials where your logo is front and center, estate planning and legal support. Our tax attorneys are available to meet with you and your clients and or their advisors. Banking expertise, negotiations, loan document and renewal support, policy management and service, and a team of six product and design analysts. Thank you, Finseca, for allowing us to share with you today. I'm looking forward to spending the next few days learning from many of you, seeing old friends, and making new ones. I hope you can all take something back today and go create some raving fans in your worlds. Thank you.